Hey guys, want to do a quick update on the Yamaha Honda here. It's my IT175 with the Honda clone engine. I had to do some modifications to it, so I'm going to show you the things I had to do here. Okay, so the first modification I had to make was to the carburetor. Now the carburetor was mounted directly to the engine, and apparently that's a big no-no, and I didn't know that. And only one other person commented that I may have trouble with that on my channel. So I think a lot of people don't know this, or maybe they do and just didn't think about it. But if you mount the carburetor directly onto the head, what happens is the heat transfers directly into the carburetor and gasoline boils at 100 degrees F, or right around there. And so the gas would boil in the carburetor. And the reason I know that is because as I was traveling down the trail, the bike would start to break up really bad after about a minute of riding or less, and I couldn't accelerate, and it certainly would not idle. It would come down to an idle and just die. And I found this out by, I had the air cleaner off one time when I came back, and I noticed gas was just popping out of the carburetor, and then my clear fuel line, I could see bubbles coming up the clear fuel line. And that gave an indication that, you know, definitely there was something going on with boiling or something. And I did a quick Google search and found out that, yeah, you can't do this. You need about a quarter inch insulator, anything that's rubber that could take the heat, or phenolic material or something. So I did find a quarter inch one, but I didn't like that one just because, as you can see, my engine kind of sits this way a little bit, and I really needed the carburetor to sit straight so that my float would be right. And so what I did was I found this one that actually has this correct angle on it right here, and put the carburetor exactly level. So now I can set the floats correctly, and everything seems to run right. And now I don't get that boiling because I have this separation, and the carburetor actually stays cold, the engine's hot. So that definitely that helped out a lot there. So let me show you something else I had to do. Okay, so another modification I had to make was on the brake system here, the rear brake. The brake rod was actually attached down here. And you can see there's this really steep angle here that the brake rod had to go on. And every time you hit a bump, as the rear tire would go up like that, the brake would kick in. And it would slow you down, and you could, you know, you hit a bump and the rear tire would lock up, and it was really a pain. So what I had to do is add this piece of metal here. I brought it up higher to get the brake rod more in line and also closer to the pivot point here. And when I did that, now as you bounce up and down on the bike, this doesn't even move. It doesn't even pull on it unless you hit the brake here like that. It works exactly like it should now. The other thing I had to do is I had to move the mounting point here in about a quarter inch, about that much. I cut it off, took the material that I cut off of there and stuck it on the back side. And that's because the Kickstarter kept hitting it and would get stuck. You can still see it rubs a little bit, but not nearly as much as it used to. So that worked out a lot better too. So now the bike, as you travel down the trail, the brake doesn't kick in on you, and that was was really annoying. Okay, so the next modification I made was to the foot pegs. Now they used to be down here. This whole bracket was turned around. They were sitting down here. They were way too low. And what would happen is you go around the corner, on the trail, and they would kind of dig in, or your feet would hit. It just didn't feel right. Plus they were, you'd feel like you're standing up on the bike when you're sitting on it. There was just so much gap between here and there. So I turned them around, readjusted them so that it would be up here, put a new pin in here, welded in the back so that, you know, it would hold it in place. And now they feel more comfortable, feels more like the original position for them. You can see the original bike came around this way, and they basically sat right about here. So I had to readjust the brake and, you know, get it in line, which is, it's perfectly where it should be now. And also the gear shift lever picked it up a little bit and readjusted it, so now it's in the right position. So definitely feels much better as you travel down the trail. You don't feel like you're standing up on the bike, and you can make corners without hitting the ground. So got much better clearance now. Yeah, here's the other side. You can see the pegs up higher, gear shift levers up higher. Definitely a more comfortable position to ride. Okay, so the last thing I did, this bike used to be a 6-volt system, and it just ran off of a generator right on the engine itself. Well, it turns out this engine has a generator built in. I didn't realize that. I noticed that when I was, hooking up the CDI box, there was three extra wires, and I figured it had to be some sort of generator system, but I wasn't going to worry about it until I actually got everything running. So once I got it all running, I did put a voltmeter on it and found out, yep, there was a generator. Two wires are for the generator and one for ground. So I bought a 12-volt regulator and wired it in. So now I have front and rear lights on the bike. I converted it over 12-volt. I was able to find one for the old Yamaha headlight here. They made one exactly for it that would fit in there, but it's 12-volt rather than 6. So that worked out perfect. And the rear light, just put a regular 12-volt bulb in there. The only thing I don't have working yet is the brake light. The wire is right here. And I do have a brake switch, but the mounting position for it is gone now. So I'm going to have to fabricate something up to hold the brake switch in place so that I can put the brake light back on. So that'll be one other modification I have to make. Sometime in the summer here I'll do that. Okay, so I had one other thing. I couldn't keep the bike running right. It would... every time I get up to high RPM, it would break up. It happened to be two different problems that I was dealing with here. One was the carburetor jetting was wrong. The original exhaust on this bike, or on the Chinese bike, I should say, was extremely restricted. And so they had a jet of it was like a 90 jet in here. And that's pretty small for a 150cc engine. So I upped that to 110, and that seemed to help a lot, except it would still break up on me, and I couldn't quite figure that out. And it was something so simple. The spark plug was fouled, and I didn't know that. It was a spark plug that came with the engine. I never even thought about it. So I went up to the motorcycle shop and had them cross-reference it, and I got a new spark plug. And as soon as I put that in, oh my gosh, what a difference. The thing, it starts right up first kick now and takes off like you wouldn't believe. It's got good torque, and now it'll do about 55 miles an hour I've had it hit, and that's pretty good for this big bike. I'll tell you, it's a heavy bike, so definitely the performance, I'm real happy with the performance. The gear ratio that I picked for it was a 13 front sprocket and a 39 rear, so yeah, it's about 3-to-1. I may adjust that some more, we'll see, but it definitely performs well enough for me. I think we're going to have a lot of fun on this when it comes to trail riding. Guys, thanks for watching.